In this video, we're continuing points in the coordinates planes worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free geometry worksheet that they provide. So we're continuing on with our previous directions, which say state the coordinates of each point. So picking up with number 4, we have points E through N. Now, as a quick reminder, positive, 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 negative, 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 and then negative, positive. So let's start with point E. Point E, we can see, is going to be positive and negative since it falls in this quadrant. And we're going 5 to the right and 9 down. So that's going to be positive 5, negative 9. F falls in the same quadrant as E, and it also is positive 5, so 5 to the right. However, it's 4 down. So we're going to have a positive 5 and a negative 4. Now let's look for point G. Point G is in the quadrant where X is positive and Y is positive. So you can see that for G, we needed to go 10 to the right and we'll need to go 4 up. So G is going to be 10, 4. And remember, our X coordinates are listed first and then our Y coordinate. H, you can see, is at the origin. We're moving 0 in the X direction and 0 in the Y direction for H. Therefore, H is 0, 0. I is in the same quadrant as G, positive, positive. And for X, we moved 3, and for Y, we moved 4. So I is 3, 4. In J, we're in the quadrant where both X and Y are negative. So we're moving 3 to the left, so we'll have negative 3 for X, and then 10 down, so negative 10 for Y. So J is negative 3, negative 10. Locating point K, we can see that K is in the quadrant where X is negative and Y is positive. So for K, we're moving 7 to the left, so a negative 7 for X, and 2 up, so a positive 2 for Y. So K is negative 7, positive 2. For point L, we're moving 7 to the left, so negative 7 for X, and we're also moving 7 down, so negative 7 for Y. L is at negative 7, negative 7. M, we're positive in both directions. That's 10 in the X direction and a positive 2 in the Y direction. And lastly, let's look for point N. N is plotted at negative 3 for X, since we had to move 3 to the left of that origin, and negative 8 for Y, since we had to move down 8 past that origin. So negative 3, negative 8 is our coordinate for N. The next part of this worksheet says to state the quadrant or axis that each point lies in. We briefly went over quadrants before we started plotting number 4. Now let's label those. When X is positive and Y is positive, we're going to be in this quadrant. This quadrant is labeled quadrant 1. And when labeling quadrants, we use Roman numerals. And you can see there's 4 quadrants, and they're going to be labeled 1, 2, 3, and 4. And from there, we are going to label our quadrants counterclockwise. So when X is negative and Y is positive, we will be in this quadrant, quadrant number 2. Continuing on our clockwise path, we will get to quadrant number 3. Quadrant number 3 is when both X and Y are negative. And then lastly, we have quadrant number 4. Quadrant number 4 occurs when x is positive and y is negative. And if you get confused at what number each quadrant is, just remember you're starting where both x and y are positive, and you're moving counterclockwise. So then to quadrant 2, quadrant 3, and then quadrant 4. So let's take a look at number 5. Number 5 says the state, the quadrant, or axis that each point lies in. So we're going to look at point L, K, and then J. The L coordinate gives us is negative 2, positive 1. So when x is negative, we're on the left-hand side of the y-axis, so somewhere over here. And when y is positive, we're above the x-axis, which is up here. That intersection occurs at quadrant number 2. X is negative, y is positive. So L will be in quadrant 2. For K, we're at negative 3, negative 2. So let's go ahead and plot K. Moving 3 to the left and 2 down, here is our point K, and you can see that that falls in quadrant 3. Now let's look at point J. Both X and Y are positive, and that's where we start labeling our quadrants. So we know that this is quadrant 1. Since J is positive 3, positive 1. And number 6, we're looking at T, U, and V. I'm going to do a quick sketch of my quadrants. So we have quadrant 1, positive, positive, quadrant 2, negative, positive, quadrant 3, negative, negative, and quadrant 4, positive, negative. Here's my x-axis, and here is my y-axis. So T is negative 3, positive 5, so that's negative x, positive y, which falls in quadrant 2. U is at point 1, 0, which, since we're not moving vertically, we know that that point will fall on the x-axis. V, we're at negative x, positive y. Negative x, positive y, again, is quadrant 2. In number 7, we have point S, which is positive x, negative y. Positive x, negative y. We're going to get quadrant number 4. For T, we have positive x, positive y. Positive x, positive y is quadrant number 1. And lastly, for number 7, we have point U. That's a negative x and a positive y. So that's going to be negative x, positive y, quadrant 2. And lastly, for stating the quadrant or axis, we have R, Q, and P. R is at point 7, 0, so it's positive in the x. However, we're not moving any vertically, so it's going to fall on the x-axis. For Q, we're moving positive 8, so that's a positive in the x, and negative 1, so that's negative in the y. Positive negative is quadrant 4. And lastly, P. We're moving 3 in the x direction, but we aren't moving any vertically, so that point, just like R, falls on the x-axis. And if we had a point, let's say, Z, that was 0 in the x and some number in the y, let's say 5, since we weren't moving any horizontally and we only moved vertically, that would fall on the y-axis. Now on to our critical thinking questions. It says, state the coordinates of the endpoints of a line segment that intersect the y-axis. So I'll go ahead and draw my coordinate system. Here's the x-axis, here's the y-axis, and we're trying to state coordinates of the endpoints of a line segment that intersect the y-axis. So in order to intersect the y-axis, our line needs to cross it. So the line I'm going to draw that crosses the y-axis will be this line here. I'll just make a horizontal line. So notice we're only moving horizontally, we're not moving vertically. So our x coordinates will be different, but our y coordinates are going to be the same. So let's pretend that this is negative 6 in the x, and this point is positive 6 in the x. Since we did not change our direction vertically, I will put both of these at the height of 3, or where y is 3. So we're starting at negative 6, 3, moving to the right until we hit positive 6, 3. So negative 6, 3 and positive 6, 3 are my example of endpoints of a line segment that intersect the y-axis. And that intersection is actually going to occur at 0, 3. Now let's look at number 10. 10 says to state the coordinates of endpoints of a line segment that is not parallel to either axis and does not intersect either axis. So I'll go ahead and draw my coordinate system. Here's my x-axis, here's my y-axis. So here's my coordinate system. I need to make a line segment that is not parallel to either axis. That means my line cannot be horizontal, since that runs parallel to the x-axis, and my line also cannot be vertical, because that runs parallel with the y-axis. It also says that it cannot intersect either axis, so I want to stay within one quadrant. So let's just do quadrant 1. So I can essentially pick two points within quadrant 1. I'm going to pick point 5, 5, which falls here, and I'll go ahead and pick 2, 2. And now I'll show you that that is indeed a line segment when I draw a line. I'm going to draw my line from point 2, 2 to 5, 5. So there is my line, that it does not run parallel to either axis and also does not intersect any axis. So my answer in my example is 2, 2, 5, 5. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. Also, if you're confused on anything that we're working on in this worksheet, go to my tutorials section on my geometry playlist where I go more in depth with each subject. These are essentially the practice problems where I'm applying what I've taught in previous tutorials. So if you're confused, go ahead and review those first. And I'll leave a link so that you know which tutorial this worksheet applies to. But once again, don't forget to click that subscribe button.